Hello and welcome to airsofttech.dk. In the last video, I showed you how to make a burst mode MOSFET for your airsoft gun. In this episode, I will take the design a little bit further and design a PCB that the electronics go onto so that you will have a much nicer looking burst mode MOSFET. Let's get started. I went here to circuits.io and create an account, and when you press new PCB we can go to the PCB editor, and in here we can add components. First we have the schematics view, and the next is the PCB view. I will find the Arduino Nano in all components. All components is components that other people has made ready to use. So let's find the Arduino Nano. So let's add that one. Add that here. So now we get an Arduino Nano. We need the MOSFET, an N-channel MOSFET. So let's add that. We need some resistors. We need some pads to solder onto, some headers, different kinds of headers, solder pad, we can turn the components around up here, name them, and we also need the signal wire from the trigger that I will call trigger. So the trigger, you can see here when I get this small red dot, I can press it and connect it to other components. The MOSFET. The gate, drain, and source. The source is connected to the LiPo negative side, the drain from the motor negative side, from the LiPo positive, there is a straight wire onto the motor positive, but from the LiPo positive, we also need to connect it to the VIN voltage, input voltage. Let's go to the website and check it out. First MOSFET. I have the schematics down here. D5 is the gate that goes through a resistor to the gate pin. So that is what I'm trying to connect here. So now we have connected the VIN directly to the LiPo positive to give it power. We have a 10K resistor, 10K kilo ohms. This one is not kilo ohms, this is just 22 ohms, and this is 20, and this is 10 kilo ohms, and we have one at 1 kilo ohm, 1K. So now I believe that I have all the components in my schematic. So now it's time to go to the PCB view. First, let's just give it the project a name. Whatever, you can give it descriptions and stuff like that. So when you are done in the schematics view, we can go over to the PCB view. Now here you have an overview of all your components and their physical size. This is the Arduino Nano that I will place on the board somewhere. We have the small in-channel MOSFET. And up here you have a button saying change footprint. And when you change footprint, you can decide the size that it should have. So you can go to these small ones or whatever you want. So down here in the button, you can see all the kinds of footprints that we want and the name of the packages that they come in. I usually have the ones that is called TO220. I don't think that MOSFET has the one I want, so I go back and change it to the other MOSFET. See, this is the package I wanted. I want the SO220, but lying down like this. This is how I usually do it, but as you can see, there's lots of different kinds of packages. These small footprints are surface mount components. I have just ordered some surface mount components. So the board that I will be ordering will look a little bit different than the one I will be making here. So my idea here is that I have the LiPo battery on one side of the board. And on the other side, I will have the motor connectors. You have this layers view over here as well. And the layers view can switch between top and bottom. When you switch to bottom, some things go blue. And that's because everything that is highlighted in bright blue color is what you will have to have as a copper on the bottom side of the board. On the top side here, you will see with highlighted in red what will be copper on the top side. The MOSFET I want to change that, and I can do that to put it on the bottom by just selecting bottom here. So now, as you can see, this one is designed to go on the bottom of the PCB. And the idea here of putting it on the bottom is that I can make the board quite a bit smaller. So we go to copper trace, and when you are in the copper trace mode, you can select from the drop down how big trace you want. For large currents, you need at least this size. I will be going with quite a bigger size to get as much power as I can. Then you click the component you want to connect, and you can draw the lines. If I click again, I lock on. See, right now I have locked this position in. If I click again, I can lock the next position in. And by just switching over here to bottom, it will make a small black dot. That will mean it will drill through the board and come out on the bottom side. And now I can connect this to here. So now I have a connection here. So now the green line disappeared. And now I just need to do the rest of the green lines. So you can also just stop them on another track. But I did have to make some changes. I have connected some of the wires wrong over here. Gate, drain, source. Gate. Through the resistor to the digital pin, drain from the motor and source to the negative side of the battery. This is basically the board that I will be ordering. I just moved things quite a bit closer so that I can make it smaller. Let me show you my board. This is my board, the schematic. And this is how I made it smaller. And I added some text, airsofttech.dk. So this is the board that I will be ordering. And it also has some small resistors on it. One person has asked me if there is a switch so that they can have the MOSFET on the gun and switch on and off burst mode. In my design right here, I do not have that switch because if I want to turn off burst mode, the thing I want to do is just to disconnect the MOSFET, because I add to the pads, I add connectors so that I can disconnect the MOSFET and then reconnect another MOSFET that is smaller and does not have burst mode on it. So that is how I do the switch. I switch the entire board to a board that does not have it on. But if you want to have one board where you want to have a switch to turn on and off the MOSFET feature, we can do that as well. So first we need to go in to add a switch, a slide switch for example. We have ground and 5 volts on the two pins, and then the output goes to, for example, digital pin, let's say digital pin 2. So now the switch will switch between ground and 5 volts. So depending on what position the switch is in, the digital pin 2 will see either 0 volts or 5 volts. On here I have set it on digital pin 4. So I will be doing that. If you use some input voltage directly or use that ground directly, then you could add a resistor. But I just use the ground and the 5 volts from the Arduino. And that is a regulated power source, so it is safe to do that directly into the digital pins. See, and now actually right here I can see I am having trouble running the big fat traces. But because this is only a signal, you can use a signal wire instead. And in the code that I made here, over here, it shows that I can read the switch, and if it's high, then I use the MOSFET, or if not, it does not use the burst mode. So in that way, I can turn on and off burst mode. Let's go to my profile, open the board design. So this is the PCB design for my YouTube video burst mode MOSFET. Down here you can download the Gerber files, and these Gerber files is what you use to order the parts, the PCB. When you have downloaded them, you can go to another page to order the PCB. I'm not promoting this company or anything. I do not know how good they are. There might be better companies, but this company is very simple at least. Start now, select your file, the file, uploading your file, give it a name, a description, and your email address. And when you're done, you just press continue. After a small signing in process where you make your profile, you get to this page that will show you how your board will look. So the board will look like this, with room for the switch, room for the MOSFET, room for the three resistors, room for the Arduino, and the pads on the top. All you gotta do is approve an order, enter your address, and pay for your circuits. Let's go to the approve an order. You will be ordering three at least. You have to order at least three boards, but for three boards it's $17. So I think that's quite fair. If you want extra thickness on your copper, I very much suggest that you do, because all of these traces, this thick traces needs to carry a lot of current from your motor. So I strongly suggest that you order thicker copper. That will increase the price a little bit, but most importantly, for these guys, it takes 3 weeks for it to ship before it ships. And then of course there's some shipping as well, shipping time. Check out, pay, and that's it. You're done.